No reprieve for motorists as another massive hike in local pump prices looms this week. Diesel prices may jump by up to 12 pesos per liter, while gasoline may rise by 7 pesos and 20 centavos per liter. Kerosene prices also seem to go up by nearly 10 pesos per liter. The spike reflects last week's skyrocketing prices in the world oil market after global benchmark Brent crude soared to $139 per barrel over fears of supply disruptions following the conflict between Russia and Ukraine. This will mark the 11th round of oil price hikes in the country this year. The Energy Department, meanwhile, cannot say for sure if oil price hikes will continue in the coming weeks.
Napaka-volatile po ng presyuhan sa international market. Kamukha po nung March 8, nung sumipa po siya dahil nga po sa pagbaba ng mga imports ni Russia. But the following day, bumaba din po siya dahil nagkaroon po ng sort ng parang negotiation din naman po yung UAE ambassador sa United States na i-temper, mag-produce na ulit sila ng malaking production ng oil para ma-offset man lang yung kawalan ng Russia. Patuloy po yung pag-apilan natin sa ating stakeholders, ang oil companies, na hanggat maaari, patuloy po yung ibigay nilang part ng corporate social responsibility nila, yung mga discount po. At nung nakaraang linggo po, may oil companies na nag-implement ng staggered implementation. At meron din pong oil companies na hindi nag-implement ng kanyang adjustment. So hopefully, makinig po yung ating mga kasama sa industriya para maibsan kahit paano yung bigat na nadarama natin.
A group of local fishermen are set to hold a so-called fishing strike to protest the continuous oil price hikes. Pamalakaya is calling on small fisher folk and operators of commercial fishing vessels all across the country to join the strike on March 15th. They're also slamming the Duterte administration for allowing giant oil firms to allegedly overprice their goods. Supermarket operators are also meet today to discuss a possible increase in the prices of goods as the higher fuel prices push production and transport costs higher.
Walang gusto magtaas ng presyo ng mga manufacturers, pero yung iba kailangan na talaga magtaas dahil yun na nga, yung cost of oil or gas, no? Gasoline, no? Fuel in their component sa production ay medyo malaki. Pipilita ng mga manufacturers na maghigpit ng kanilang costs, no, of operation, no, pero yun na, yung iba hindi na kaya.
Senator Franklin Tirilon reiterates his call for the Duterte administration to suspend the collection of fuel excise taxes. Tirilon says the train law must be interpreted liberally to help sectors struggling amid soaring oil prices.
Last December, the BIR suspended the continued collection of the VAT, value added tax, on exporters who were being charged with VAT on purchases for on goods for export, materials on goods for export. And the BIR suspended that. Until now, it is suspended. So if there is a will, there is a way. Kung gusto talaga natin, if they want, sigurado talaga, call Congress to a special session and I can assure you that the congressmen and the senators will react favorably. In one day, we can pass a resolution which has the effect of a law to suspend the collection of the excise tax on fuel.
But for Philippines Central Bank Governor Benjamin Diokno, the government subsidy program for transport workers, farmers, and fisher folk groups is good enough for now.
On the tax cut, I understand that the revenue loss is approximately 100 billion. That's a big sum of money. It means less budgetary allocation for many essential government programs and projects, including spending for education, health, and social welfare. So the beneficiaries of such programs are the biggest losers. The major beneficiaries of the oil tax cut are the rich and the private car owners.